So here we are. This is near the end of Ambriel's mod, her story. You can't hide. Time for you humans to learn your place. We've been searching for this dragon. We just need to talk to the dragon. But there's some bandits in the neighborhood. There's some Thalmor.
That's not a very promising place.
Neighborhood, they're fighting with the dragon, hopefully the Thalmor. I have to remember to not talk to the dragon until all the Thalmor and all the bandits are dead. Otherwise it breaks the quest. Whoever made this mod triggers the beginning of the dragon dialogue before the dragon's ready to even talk to you. So I gotta be careful not to even bump into the dragon. Until I'm ready. Okay, let's see what happens now.
Dragonborn. Finally. This Thalmor bandmen have bound me to this place.
Sounds like the same guy who does the Talos voice.
Grown. Capran. I am not able to flee. Our fight ends.
Uh-oh. I forgot to kill an extra person. Oh, what is this guy? An assassin? Who are you? He doesn't even show up on my radar.
Is someone there?
No.
Oh, you killed a guy.
Safe, at last.
At last, okay. A Boethian cultist. That's weird. He just spawned out of nowhere. I'm trying very careful to not break Ambriel's quest line. And here comes this Boethia recluse who's been released upon the world. Upon the Nirn. For me to kill. Where's the stupid book he gives me? There we go. Might as well start that quest while I'm ahead. While I'm starting this quest with the dragon. Okay, where were we? Can you still talk to me? Okay, he's not broken.
Dragonborn.
Yeah.
Grown.
Yeah, fast
forward. Capran. I am Desdinok. My death is unavoidable. And you know this. As I absorbed Kataria's soul, I was out of Sithis's hands. That was the side effect. Thus Sithis did not expect.
Okay, so Kataria is Ambriel's mom. Me.
And now...
I think that was my Dramar that died.
Ambriel.
Oh no, that was Ambriel's Sabercat? I don't know.
Set me free.
Too much stuff in this game.
Dieu Ablon, as Driem. By thy mercy, the death will bring the peace.
Yeah.
I haven't had in life.
So basically, all the NPCs I meet in this mod are on their last leg.
Isn't it a bit dangerous for a chatter in this place?
We pretty much kill every NPC we come across in her backstory.
Yes, I thought that a dragon would try to kill us. But what does that mean? He absorbed my mother's soul? You will have to explain that to me.
One thing I like about Vilya is that you don't kill all of the NPCs in her quest line. Let's see, is there another mod I have where I don't kill everybody I meet?
Why? Tell me what is going on here. No, we have to save her. I couldn't prevent her death, but I will not allow her soul to vanish. There must be another way. So, if I try to save her soul and spare Torsa, Sithis will win and our world will be destroyed? I'm glad you told me the truth. And I know what I have to do now. Mother, forgive me.
So she absorbs the dragon's soul, or she kills the dragon outright with just a sword? Because poof, and the dragon's gone. I don't understand this part. It's very hocus pocus.
Courageous decision and brave.
And then she's absorbing her mom's power, but even though I'm lighting up. Anyway, something happened. The game crashed. I forget. We're gonna try this again. I don't remember. I think I had to answer the phone or something. I think my job was calling me, so I had to answer the phone.
Maybe it'll rain later.
It'll give me another chance to try this. Okay. Cue the Boethian. The Bohemian cultist. Let's kill him first if we can. Yeah. You're all gonna submit. Just don't hurt the dragon.
Relax. There's no danger anymore.
Are you sure? Because I see violence up ahead in my sound bar here. I don't trust her.
Difficult to see through this fog. I hope it holds no nasty surprises.
I know, huh? Let's double check here. Okay, can I just fast forward through this, because I don't
Dragon know. Vien Grod.
Yeah.
You do not need Dieu Ablon.
Yeah. Okay, let's fast forward through her dialogue.
By thy mercy, the death.
Oh, that's right. Something with Rode had happened.
I haven't had in life.
An amulet of Mara. You're looking for Mara.
Oh.
Let me know if there's
anything
else. Is it
a bit dangerous for a chatter in this place? Yes. You will have to explain that to me.
Man, we got some
Why?
Script lag going
Tell
on here.
Tell me what. No. We have. So, if I try to save
Who's
her soul
fighting the dragon?
And spare Torsa, Sithis will win and our world will be destroyed?
Don't break my quest.
I'm glad you told me the truth.
Yeah.
And no. I know what I have to do now. Mother.
She absorbs the powers, but I'm absorbing the power too. I think that's just a game engine thing. Cause see, the mom shows up.
This was a courageous decision and brave. My soul is free, and this has more power on me.
What?
Thank you. Now I can rest in peace.
I don't understand the sounds that are coming out of your mouth. Man, my EMB makes this look really bizarre. Okay, so this time, so I absorb the dragon, Ambriel absorbs her mom. I see what's going on. I see what they're doing. It's all very trickery here. And then Ambriel turns into a dragon.
No.
It's very spaghetti sci-fi-ish in a cinematic way.
In all the centuries, I have had a lot of sad, but also a lot of nice experiences.
Oh, you got a new outfit out of the whole
but
thing.
But I must accept my fate. Lord Nerefin will pay for this, and he will regret his covenant with Sithis. I'm glad that you've told me the truth. You trusted me to make the right decision. Confidence? Or perhaps there's something more?
Oh, I messed up here.
I haven't had much time for personal thoughts and feelings, but I have got a strong feeling about a special bond to you. Don't take this the wrong way, not immediately, but we will see what the time will bring.
If you say maybe to her, then to her she's saying yes.
Oh, I'm speechless. In the recent centuries, I have not conducted such talks. But let us talk later. At the moment, we should decide where to continue our fight against Nerifin and Sithis. We should visit the Temple of Talos again, or go see Sancturia. Let's go then.
She gets very clingy at this point. I said maybe we'd be a thing. Because I thought there's an option to get out later on if I change my mind.
I'm almost out of arrows. We should get some new projectiles soon.
But she's already planning the wedding in her head right now at this moment.
Yes, my dear?
See? I'm thinking, oh no. See, with Vilya, okay.
But remember,
you can always redirect Vilya.
Not a pack horse.
When Vilya tries to plant a seed in your mind that the two of you will get married one day, you can always remind her, oh, we're just friends, remember? Anyway, I took Ambriel's clothes. I want to see what she says about being naked. Make sure that script is working. I'm just seeing how much script lag I've got.
Could you give me some clothes? It's too public here. Very gallant.
Okay, so she just spawns new clothes for herself. So now we got copies of...
Hey! What troubles you, darling?
We got copies of her clothes, I think.
Okay, then.
She won't put on anything else. She'll always wear the dragon outfit. The dragonborn outfit. Dragon bone outfit.
Okay. Oh, you have got a nice amulet. I feel hale and hearty. Let's tame a dragon. Yes? Ooh, I hope it's jewelry. Shiny trinkets are a princess's best. Okay, honey.
Meanwhile, what's going on with Rode? Why are you in it?
I have no weapons at the moment. Remember that if we...
Oh, I can't click on Rode. Hey. What's going on? Rode seems out of it at the moment.
Always a pleasure.
I think I need to tell Rode to, hang tight somewhere. Not get all antsy during the dragon encounter, because he always locks up on me. I don't know why. Maybe I'm not supposed to bring a follower with me when I talk to Torsil, or whatever that dragon's name was. Torsil? Come on, Rode, snap out of it. Soon after this, I deleted Rode from my game, I think. Because he was talking like a Dunmer. That's the voice he uses, and he refers to himself as a Dunmer. Forever.
And now, we share our lives.
Oh, okay. Yeah, she can't be talking like that to me. Two girls? No. If I was a dude, I wouldn't have a problem with her talking to me that way. But... Yes, I'm one of those people.
You have got a nice amulet.
Okay.
Yes?
So we redid the whole thing.
Okay.
Now I'm just checking to see if she's calling me darling.
An amulet of Mara. You're looking for marriage, then. I'll be right here, then.
Oh! I forgot. I told Rode to stay put. Now he needs to come follow
ready
me.
To get moving.
Let's go.
I don't have healing potions anymore.
Lead the way.
Could I please have some?
Okay. So Rode's working. Ambriel wants to stay single.
But remember,
all is good in Nern.
Not a pack horse.
Okay, what else? She's low on magic potions.
Okay then.
So now we just need to go and fight the guys. We need to go to Cyrodiil and fight the Senate. That had been taken over by Ambriel's brother.
No weapons means bad fights.
You know, spoilers. Win the game, and then Ambriel will be just a regular follower in the game, I hope. If I remember right. I think Sithis still has her hooks in us.
Can I help you?
After her quest is finished.
What do you need?
As long as the war continues, Skyrim will always be an unsafe place. Well, a good place for everybody.
I mean, weeks later, I'm still using Embriel as a main follower in my playthrough, so she must have come out rosy.
Let me know if you need anything.
Yeah, I'm getting ready to send him home. Take all of his stuff that he doesn't need.
Yes? I can help you with that.
And for some reason, steel daggers are murderous in my game.
Okay, then.
Like the iron dagger, the... You know, what's the other one? The orcish one, the dwarven one, the elven one. They're nothing. They only do like 9 damage. But the steel dagger, for whatever reason, does 24 damage in my game. Now, I don't know if that's a mod that I have installed that's doing that to the steel dagger. Because I would think the orc dagger would do more harm than a steel dagger. It just looks more lethal to me. But I may have a mod installed that tells Nords that steel weapons are awesome for them. And other weapons are pretty much useless to them, like elves and orc weapons.
If you're here for business, go ahead. Otherwise, get lost.
I always mess with that guy on the porch. But that might be it. Maybe Imperius tells my character that steel weapons are more his thing for Nords. And other weapons are just not as good. Because I notice when I have the weapon, it's lethal. When I give a steel dagger to Ambriel, that's the only weapon she wants to use. She's got this enchanted sword, but she would rather use a plain, boring steel dagger when I give one to her to kill stuff with. I just thought that was weird. And I was watching a YouTube video the other day, and the guy's NPCs were all sick. So now I'm going around checking all my NPCs to see if I've made them sick. You know, with rock joint and ataxia and all those kinds of things. And so far I haven't found an NPC that's sick. Because you have to remove the active effect from their inventory. You can't just heal them and they're cured. And they won't drink a disease potion. You know, a cure disease potion. They won't drink those if you give one to them. Because I heard a rumor, a whisper of a rumor, that NPCs can get infected by diseases. And you don't even know that they're infected. And then someone made a mod so that you can heal NPCs or something that are sick. Sounds like a back-assward way of fixing the problem. Oh, you need a mod to fix that issue. What? It shouldn't be happening in the first place. Because then the mod has to be compatible with all your NPCs that you've installed. And who's going to have a mod that does that?
Too lazy to walk, eh? Well, don't mind if you do. What's your price? Sold. She's all yours. She's already saddled up.
Oh, this horse? Man, this horse is already long dead in my game. Yeah, this is a real old video. This is almost a month. Oh, I'm stuck. I hate when that happens.